All right, welcome everyone. Chris Petri here. It's another Extreme Beginners video. We're doing a beautiful still life this time. We're going to actually cover A to Z, everything you need to know to create a wonderful still life here. We're doing some gorgeous, beautiful red roses and some white carnations. We're doing some beautiful rendering, some beautiful green apples, some gorgeous yellow lemons. We have a red delicious apple over here. We have a mustard container over here. A nice red stripe beer bottle over here. We have an artist brush right in the foreground, right here, right in the front part of our composition here. And then some background information here, a little bit of background washes and splashes and things like this. We'll show you how to do the whole thing, the whole enchilada, A to Z, on this video. Hope you'll join us. Hope you'll come along, paint along with us here. Take your time. Have fun. Hit the pause button as much as you need to. Make it a 2 or 3 day effort. Or if you want to zoom through the whole thing in a couple hours, do that too. It's up to you. You're the artist. But again, we're having fun. We're enjoying ourselves. This watercolor, that's the whole point. Have fun with your watercolors. It's a journey. Watercolor is a journey. It's not a learn it overnight deal, or you know, you're going to learn it in 2 weeks or a month or a year. Watercolor takes years to get mastery over. So just remember this. Have fun. Enjoy the process. Enjoy all the different exercises you're going to do, compositions, paintings. Take it all in. Enjoy it all. Absorb as much as you can. Put as much time in as you can. I know everyone's not the same. Some people, you just don't have the time to put in 2 or 3 hours a day. That's understandable. But whatever time you can put in on your watercolors, whatever time you invest in it, you're going to reap excellent rewards from that time that you put in. So if you can put in 15 minutes a day of drawing, and then maybe on the weekends you work 2 or 3, 4 hours on your paintings, you're going to have great success and you'll make good progress. If you can only afford to do maybe 1 hour a week, it's going to be a little slower, but you can still get good progress. You can still make progress and get beautiful paintings as you go. So always remember, the more time you put in, you're going to have a little bit of a better time figuring things out, mastering all the techniques and methods in watercolor. But in the end, no matter how much you can put in, a little bit of time or a lot of time, just have fun. Whatever way you're going to choose to work your watercolors, sometimes you'll have more time, sometimes less. Main thing is just have fun. Just enjoy. And we're going to show you here how to create this again, this wonderful still life painting with roses and carnations and green leafy forms, and then some fruits and lemons and apples and oranges and a nice beer bottle here and a nice mustard container here with a white tablecloth and a blue background, a little bit of a bluish purple background with some splashes of color and things like this. So let's get together here each week. Hit the subscribe button. If you haven't subscribed before on my channel, please don't lose track of me. Hit the subscribe button. And I also, too, I always say, if you can, in the description box below, there's my book. Buy my book. It's like a user manual for everything I'm doing here on YouTube. So if you want to follow me on YouTube and you want to get better at your watercolors, best thing to do is to grab my book in the description box below. You can check out my book. I show you all the pages, everything that's in there, all the paintings. And then this way you really have a great companion as you work along with us here on YouTube, so that you can refer back to all of the colors we're using, the brushes, the pencils, the supplies that we use, and also, too, all the methods and techniques we use in watercolor, because I cover that all in my book. So I'm kind of just giving you the great advantage. If you can get out there, grab my book, and then start working here on YouTube and just work along with my YouTube videos and my book, use those both together, you'll get a really great outcome from that, okay? You'll progress really well. So let's get started. In just a second, we'll start doing our pencil drawing. Okay, be right back. All right, you've seen the finished painting. So now we're just going to work from our the first 30 seconds or 1 minute of the painting. So if you can screen capture or screenshot the first minute of the painting that we just showed, you can get the feel of what you're going to be looking for, your finished product, what you want to kind of aim for your finished watercolor painting. So let's get started here with our drawing. First thing we'll do is we'll get a just a really nice border around our paper here. And I'll try to get this across the whole paper. Like that. Okay, so we have a rectangle there with our pencil. Then the next thing we want to do is we want to sort of do a preliminary sketch. And we talk about this a lot in my videos. And I also, if you'll notice below in this description box below, I have my new book, Methods for Success. And basically, you'll see the book, you'll see where you can purchase it. You'll also see, if you want to, you can watch a video. I did a quick video on YouTube, which shows you in 60 seconds, it shows you each page of the book. So you see all the artwork, all the paintings that are in there. We have tons of paintings in that book, and I hope you'll pick up my new book. You can work from it. You can use it as a study tool. You can use it as reference. You can work from all the paintings that are in there. There's literally just 20, 30, 40 paintings in there. You can work from all of them, paint them yourself, have an enjoyable time. I'm really excited about my new book because really, I know if you purchase my book, you're going to see all the information you need. You're going to see all of the techniques and methods that I use in watercolor. You're going to see what kind of palettes I use, pencils, what kind of brushes I use, paper, the techniques, the methods. You're going to see also some of the really very strong design principles that I use, as well as some of the real important factors that you have to kind of know about watercolor to get really good results. So I have it all in my book. I'm hoping you're going to get my book. It's kind of like a user's manual. If you're here watching on my channel and you're, making some progress and you're trying out a few videos here and there, my book is the perfect companion to my YouTube channel here, to my videos. So I'm hoping that you're going to pick up my book. It's really a phenomenal price for the information that you get. All of the, again, it's like a user's manual that ties right in here to all of our videos. So you'll find it that it's just going to help you to create more beautiful paintings and to get more mastery over watercolor. So again, let's get started here with our drawing. First thing we're going to do is our preliminary drawing, and I cover my preliminary drawing style in my book, as well as the final contour drawing. Again, I cover that in my book. All these things, again, that are the major milestones of my technique, my methods in watercolor, are all covered in my book. So I'm hoping, you're going to pick that up. It's a great value right on Amazon. Again, you'll see it right in the in the description box below. But let's get started here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to kind of just take ourselves into the painting itself and say, well, what are we going to try to do here? We're going to try to get the vase and the flowers. That's the first thing. That's the predominant portion of the painting that looks the most dominant. So I'll just do a quick, very light preliminary sketch of the vase and the handle that comes down like this. You can barely see that probably on the video right now, but I have to do this really light sketch first so that you can kind of see that this preliminary sketch is very important. You want to basically have a good solid preliminary sketch of what you're going to do in your painting. We're going to have some other leaf forms here. I'm just doing, again, a light sketch. This is going to be a beautiful red rose here. Okay. Again, I'm doing this very loosely. I don't want to get too worried about every detail. Then we have a green apple here. And another green apple over here. And then down here, we have a lemon. And another lemon over here, larger lemon. And okay, over here's the green apple, large green apple there. And then we have an orange. Some shadows. And then over here we have another lemon. And then here we have our beer bottle. So we're going to make a little enjoyable beer bottle here. Okay, and that beer bottle is sort of right along the edge of the paper here. So I hope you don't mind that. And then we have the logo across the beer bottle, like this. And then we have a little bit of script here. And then, well, wow, here we have a paintbrush. Let's do a watercolor paintbrush here. So across here, we're going to do the paintbrush. The ferrule. And then the hairs of the brush, like that. Okay. And then what do we have over here? Oh, over here we have a gorgeous mustard jar. And then over there we have, finally, over here we have a red delicious apple. And I'm just going to do the stems of some of the apples here, these two apples. Okay. All right, I've done the preliminary sketch. You can barely see it. I understand that. That's why I'm going to go over this with a darker sketch. But I just want to kind of show you how I'm kind of working around my entire paper really quickly, really loosely, just to get that preliminary sketch in. And then what we'll do now is next, I'm going to do that darker pencil line over the top of these lighter pencil lines. That's going to give us our contour drawing. And again, in my book, I cover that. The contour drawing is a very important part of your drawing process before you start painting. You want to have your preliminary sketch. We just did that here, basically getting everything you want to into your painting. And then after that, you're going to go over with a darker pencil line. We're going to do that right now, okay? So we're just going to take a quick break, and we'll come right back, and we'll do a darker pencil line, which is going to be our contour drawing, which basically we're just going to kind of go over the whole entire light sketch we just did with a darker pencil line. That's all that really is, okay? But we have to do that really light pencil line first so we kind of get everything in the right place, because if you want to adjust a few things here and there, it's a lot easier to erase and adjust things if you make a really light pencil sketch like we just did now. If you go in and do a really dark pencil sketch or on your paper at this point, then you might say, oh, then you might have a couple of changes you want to make, and then it'll be like, oh, it's really difficult because you have dark pencil lines on there. You're going to be erasing and erasing and erasing with your kneaded eraser. Here, you don't have to do that. If you do your preliminary sketch first, like we just did here, you'll get that first light, super light sketch in. And then when everything is in the right spot and you step back and you look and you say, yeah, that looks good. Or, oh, I got to make a few changes here, and you'll add a few changes once in a while to a few things in your drawing. Then that's perfect. Then you go back in after that and do your darker pencil line over the top. and everything works out great, because basically your contour drawing is essentially you're just going over the top of your preliminary sketch for the most part, but you are redrawing it in a sense, because you're gonna, if you need to make any changes again, you can do those changes with your darker pencil line as you go. Okay, all right, so let's get a little quick break in here for about 5 minutes, and we'll get started with our darker pencil line, which is our contour drawing, which is going to go over the top of our preliminary sketch. And we talked about, again, preliminary sketch is real important. Get that really super light sketch where you can barely even see it on your paper, just so that you know you have your vase in the right place, your flowers, your leaf forms, you're going to have your fruits and your still life information, your paintbrush, your watercolor paintbrush, and your apples and your mustard jar, whatever you're going to be drawing in your painting. You can add other things in here that you might like to, but for the most part, I'm putting in basic, you know, things in my painting here: apples, oranges, lemons, a mustard jar, a beer bottle, and some flowers and a vase. You do all these things, you do them really super light with your first pencil sketch to get them somewhat in the right area you need them to be. And then you say, wow, yeah, everything looks good. Now you can go over with that darker contour drawing. Okay, so that contour drawing is really important. But if you need to make adjustments, it's real easy to now, because it's just a light sketch first. Hope that makes sense. Does that make sense? Hope that makes really a good amount of, hopefully it appeals to your logical mindset, if you will, that your preliminary sketch is basically just getting things in on your paper, within your rectangle, within your painting area, so that it looks good and it's in the right places. Everything's in the right spot. So if you maybe draw your flowers too large, well, then you can kind of erase a little bit and draw your flowers a little bit smaller to get them into the picture. So again, it's all about your layout of your painting is really crucial. So that's why you do that light sketch first. Then you go over that with your darker contour drawing. And that's really where you draw in everything really the way you want it to look. And you can leave those pencil lines in there. That looks really good if you're going to paint over the top of your darker pencil lines. You'll see some of the gorgeous, beautiful lines that you draw in with your contour drawing. So let's do that next. But again, I can't explain the importance of it more fully than just your preliminary sketch is real important, because that gets you everything in the right place at the right time on your rectangle, in your painting. And then from there, you can go over with your darker pencil lines for your contour drawing. And that means that you'll already have everything all set, and you can just go over with your darker pencil lines, and you can just kind of like trace over what you've already done for the most part. And that'll get you the results you want. Okay, so again, let's take a quick break and then we'll get started again. Okay, here we go. I'm going to go with a little bit of a darker lead. This is an 8B lead pencil. It's got a little bit of a darker lead content. So I'll use that for my drawing here. So let's start out. I'm going to start out right here at the vase, and you'll see that I try to okay, and then our apples over here, green apple. Okay, green apple here. Stem, green apple there. Then we have an orange over here. We have a shadow under the orange, like that. And there's some more shadows over here. And then we have another lemon here. And then with this lemon, we have another shadow here. Then we have our paintbrush, our watercolor paintbrush. Look at that. And our paintbrush is there. Like that. And then another lemon over here. And a shadow for our lemon over here. And another green apple over here. Wow, look at that. How good that looks here. We're doing our... Then we have our mustard jar. So we have the jar here. Like this, and like this. Like that. And this is also too. Shadow there. Then we have our red delicious apple. Look at how good this is going to look. We're going to paint this with gorgeous red paint here, but we're just going to first get the pencil drawing in. Like this. Then we have the indentation of the apple at the top. And we have, what else do we have here? We have the really nice ye old mustard jar. And we have the two lemons, two green apples, an orange. We have another yellow lemon here. It's over here by the and this here is our beer bottle. We have a red stripe beer bottle here. And we have a label there. And we have a emblem there. And there might be some shadow there on the beer bottle. And then we have a little bit of a shadow under here, under the watercolor paintbrush. And this is over here, this bit of a shadow over here under this red delicious apple. And then let's continue on here. So this is the vase. All right, so we are really... There we go. We have our table. We just kind of drew in our table back here. The edge of the table back here. Okay, that looks good. Edge of the table back here. And then the next thing we want to do is sharpen our pencil again, but we want to take a quick break. We've been doing a lot of drawing here. And I always mention, if you're drawing a lot, it takes concentration. Drawing is not an easy task sometimes. So don't feel like, you know, you have to just keep going and going and going with your pencil drawing. Always, you know, if you're doing a pencil drawing, maybe you work 15, 20 minutes and you take a break and then you come back after 5 or 10 minutes. And then you work another 10 or 15 minutes, and that really will help you a lot if you can kind of take a break, you know, reset your concentration, get a little bit of rest. You'll feel much better. You'll come back in. You'll be able to sort of concentrate a little better as you're doing your last portion of your drawing here. So the next thing I'm going to do is, once I take a break for 5 or 10 minutes, I'm going to actually come in here and I'll do the last bits of flowers here in this bouquet here, in this vase. And I think that'll be it. We'll have everything in. All of our drawing will be completed. And we put a lot of information in here. I meant to say that. This here is like a still life painting where we put a lot of like good subject matter in here. We just put lots of apples, lemons. We put, you know, a mustard jar, a beer bottle, and then we put a vase with some really beautiful flowers and leaf forms, things like this. So I'm putting a lot into this, but I just want you to know that we can just go at a really humble pace here, get some drawing done, take a break, finish up your drawing. Then we go in and we start to do the painting, get some of your painting done, then take a break, come back, do a little more painting, take another break, and then maybe finish up your painting. Maybe you'll do your painting in three phases. You know, maybe you'll work maybe a little bit longer than that. Maybe you'll do four phases of your painting where you take breaks in between each of those four or three. It's up to you. But you'll see that we will take breaks here because it's really a game of watercolor is a game of trying to keep your concentration and your focus really strong so that you can kind of really stay on your game plan of what you want to do here in your painting. So that's all we're doing. And again, this is an extreme beginner's painting. So we have our extreme beginner's palette, which is our Prang Oval 16 palette. And basically, again, we're going to use our simple brushes. We're going to just do a couple of our extreme beginner brushes, which are synthetic brushes, which work really great with watercolor. Synthetic brushes work fantastic with watercolor paintings. So again, we're going to do all these things and more as we continue on. And I'm hoping you're really excited about this. If it's your first time here, on my video, welcome. And thank you so much for coming by. We're going to start the painting in just a few minutes. We just want to finish up our flowers. So if you want to continue on with us and keep learning and growing here in your watercolor skills, you just click on the subscribe button on the right-hand side below. That means you'll just be sticking with us here week after week and month after month as we keep going and working. And you'll just keep picking up on all of the information that we're sharing here. That'll make you really kind of a better artist. You'll be learning more, absorbing more, really just, you know, the more you are going over the same fundamentals in watercolor, you're just going to learn it and then you're just going to use it and it's going to become part of your process of painting and that'll make you a better watercolor artist. So that's my goal here, that you become a better watercolor artist all the time. You're always increasing in your knowledge, your skills. You'll be creating better paintings. You'll be happier. The more better your paintings look, the happier you're going to be. You're just going to keep working and working and working along with us here each week as we go. So again, thank you so much for coming by. Thank you for joining along with us here. Subscribe on the right-hand side below if you haven't subscribed already, because I don't want you to lose track of what we're doing here. We're working really diligently here week after week, again, month after month, and even year after year. So keep coming back, keep learning, keep growing, keep watching the videos, keep practicing, and you're going to get better without a doubt. And so let's get started again in just a few seconds. But we want to take a quick break here. Again, we mentioned breaks are important. Take a quick break. Put my pencil down. Take a quick break. And then we'll finish up our flowers up here in the bouquet area. And then we'll start painting. Okay? Be right back. All right. We are back again. And we are going to just finish up our bouquet up here of flowers. We're going to have a rose up here. And maybe like a carnation up here and another rose over here. We'll do some different flowers, some flower shapes. So let's start out here. We'll come up. Let's do this first rose here. And we'll do some leaf forms here. And then we'll do our red rose here. Beautiful red rose. And it doesn't have to be perfect. If you can kind of get that outline of the basic shape of the rose, the outline, you're fine. You can paint in the details later. And there might be another petal you might want to go across here with a couple of petals on the rose over here. And maybe another one up here. But for the most part, that's good. And then you come over here. We're going to do some. There's another leaf form here. And a few more leaf forms over here. So we're going to kind of do this over here, a few more leaf forms there, and then we're going to have our carnation up here. That's a white carnation, and there's another white flower up here too. That's good. And then we're going to have another green leaf form up here, and another green leaf form over here, and then over here we're going to have a beautiful white rose. that. And some, and then also too, we're going to do a red, maybe a small bud of a rose over here, and then maybe another yellow flower over here, right there. And then we have some small leaf forms and shapes over here, like that. Okay, so now we have our flowers completed in our flower arrangement here in our vase. And then also too, let's not forget that, let's get those stems of all these beautiful flowers here in the in that vase. Look at that. So we just did that quickly. So we got our stems in our vase too here. We got our flowers, our roses, our carnation, another rose, a white rose over here. We have, what else do we have? Some stems, some leaf forms. And then again, we also were really excited. We got all of our fruits and our vegetables and our brushes, our beer bottle, our mustard container here. So maybe we'll do one more interesting tidbit of information over here, but I'm not sure if I'm going to add anything more to this, but if we do, you'll be the first to know. Okay. All right. So let's take a break now. We've just finished up our bouquet of flowers. That's the last thing we wanted to do. Now we have the whole complete drawing completed. Now let's start going in and adding in our painting. Let's have fun. The painting process here in this video, it's going to be wonderful. It's going to be fun. It's going to be loose, enjoyable. Maybe the drawing's a little more difficult. I would definitely say, yeah, if you're doing this drawing and you're trying to really get a beautiful composition like this, yeah, it's going to take a little bit of time. Take your time, take breaks. But once you start painting, then you're like home free. You're just doing the beautiful washes with your watercolor. You're having fun. That's the part of the process of watercolor that you have the most fun, is when you're adding in your gorgeous colors, your washes, you're having fun, splashing, adding colors. All works out great at the end when you're kind of finishing up and adding your washes of paint. Okay, so let's get started with our washes of paint next. Okay. All right, we're going to get started here. And the painting process should, again, be really fun. We're going to just actually work with the paints. We have our old Prang Oval 16 watercolor set here. We spritzed the paints before we started with a spritzer bottle, a nice Holbein spritzer bottle. You spritz the paints a little bit, get them moist before you start painting. And that's really all you have to do. I'm going to use my Simply Simmons number 9 round brush, which is a synthetic round brush. This will be the main brush I'm going to use. I think I should probably be able to do most of this painting with this brush. So I have fresh, clean water in a water bucket over here. So I just filled up a small water Holbein water bucket, small collapsible plastic water bucket. I put it over here on the right hand side. And then you can also have a tissue with you. You can hold the tissue in your hand, and then as you're working, you can take off a little bit of water on your brush if you need to make sure you're not flooding too much water onto your paper with your brush. So we're going to kind of just use this as we go. Okay, so we're going to start our painting right in the center of the painting, pretty much the center of the painting. We'll start out in the bouquet. We'll start out in the bouquet of the painting, the center here, and then we'll work the rest of the painting from that point. So I'll just get some green. So I'll use my two greens here. A little bit of brown in there to make it like an olivey green. And I'll just start doing some of the stems. So I'm just doing some of the stems right now and leaf forms. Couple of splashes. Okay, you can see I'm working my leaf form shapes first. Then we have up here some red and blue. For kind of a grayish kind of color here, just to get some of that shadow color under here, under the flower. And then let's do some blue. Around the top of the flower. Like that. There we go. Just to have some colors here starting to develop, some good colors. This is a white carnation up here on the top. Let's leave that light. We have some leaf forms up here. Like that. And then we have another white shape here. Let's go around this white rose here. With some, a little bit of color, a little bit of blue for the background here. Just do a little bit of scrubbing. But we want to paint around that white rose there. Like that. Just get some just get some wash on the paper to start to tie things together. Okay, that's the white rose here, and there's some yellow. So that's going to be where? Okay, the yellow. We're going to make that yellow flower here. Okay, yellow flower there. And then maybe a red flower up here. Look at how good that looks. So you're going to do some, you're going to start to put in some beautiful color, vibrant color, yellows and reds. Like that, some blue over here for the vase. Then up here, we're going to do some more red for the red rose up here. Beautiful red rose. So let's make the red rose up here. Let's add some blue for shadow colors for the, almost like a purple for the bottom part of the rose there. Then we go up on top of that with the more beautiful red. Like that. And then we go back in, get some more of the green, do some splashing. And I just try to get some of those beautiful green leaf forms with some splashes there. And then some more shadowing here for this rose. So over here, this rose has a little bit of shadowing there. Some more dark greens. And a couple more leaf forms like that. And some scrubbing over here with some blue and green, some splashes here like this, just to get that. Like so. And we have some more green stems like this inside the vase. Let's get those in there. Okay, and now I'll splash on some fresh clean water on the paper here, and then I'll add some of that blue. I'll just kind of swirl the brush around. And I just scrub around a little bit of wash on the paper. And I lift up a little bit too with some paper towel or tissue in case you, if you start to see some of your washes get a little bit like they're mixing and mingling too much, don't worry about it. Just lift up a little bit with your paper towel or tissue like that. Okay, and I'm going to add in a little more green leafy things here. All right, so now at this point, we've got quite a bit completed. Let's take a break, and then we'll come back. And I think what we'll start doing is, once we come back, we will start to work in these lower, this lower section here with our apples, oranges, lemons, beer bottle. We also did a beautiful mustard jar here, red delicious apple, paintbrush, artist brush here. So let's do all of the lower section now as we get started again. But let's take a quick break, and you can kind of see we have some good washes on the paper already. We're just going to get back into it in a second or two and finish up. But I think right now we are really in great shape. All right. Looks good so far. Let's, again, take a break, and we'll come back, and we'll start to work on the lower section here. All right, let's keep painting here. We have our flowers, a lot of our flowers completed. Leaf forms here in the vase. Let's keep working. Let's work left to right over here. If you're left-handed, you would work right to left like this. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to work right to left like this. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'll get a little bit of that red delicious apple color. A little bit of shadow there. A little bit of the greens there. And then let's start doing some of our, we have lots of lemons here. And we'll leave a little bit of highlights on our lemons here. And a little bit of shadow. And I'm just trying to get the shadows all the way across here. Like that. Then we can actually add in some warmer colors, reds in there, yellows, into the shadows. Okay, then we have some orange for our orange. Green apple. I'm just mixing some of that beer bottle color, which is kind of like a brownish red. And that looks good. A couple spots there. Highlights. Okay, so we have our red delicious apple coming across here, some lemons, some green apples, an orange. Let's do our, let's get our mustard jar here. A little bit of shadow and a mustard jar there, like that. Thank you. Okay, let's get our... brush here. Watercolor brush. All right, so we are just finishing up now. Okay, so I'm just going in, getting some of the shadows in. All right, that is it. We have all of our main subject matter completed right now. We have our flowers, our green leafy forms. We have our vase. We have our fruit, which is our apples, oranges, lemons. And then we have a beer bottle here and a mustard jar, kind of just to create a whole beautiful still life painting that you can be really excited about. Get excited about your still life paintings. They're really fun. You work on all your fundamentals, your basics of watercolor, basic shapes, basic colors, basic handling of your brush, your paints, your paper, your washes. So this is all just part of the fundamentals of watercolor. Have a fun time doing something like this. Try it 2, 3, 4 times. And each time you try it, you're going to get better at it, of course. Practice makes perfect. So if you're going to try this type of still life scene, please try it a few times, 2 or 3, 4 times. If you want to make it a little bit more simple, you can maybe do the flower arrangement with the vase and maybe just a couple pieces of fruit and maybe a beer bottle or a mustard jar. Maybe pick maybe a few things you like that you want to see in your still life painting, maybe a paintbrush like I did here. But the main thing is have fun, enjoy it. Get excited about the colors, the shadows. And again, the pencil drawing is like really your beginning fundamental part of your painting. So if you just do that really carefully, you know, just get in your preliminary sketch, your really light, super light sketch so that you can fit everything in your rectangle like this. Once you get that done, then you go over with your darker pencil lines just to get everything really solid looking good. And then after that, you're going right in and you're doing your painting and your washes. So I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you joined along with us here on this painting. We'll see you in next. If you want to, you can add a few little extra details here. I'll do a couple stems you can do like this. couple of details. Maybe we'll do some details there you can do. And then there's another stem here for this apple. All right. Thanks again for coming by. This is an extreme beginner's video, so enjoy it. Have a good time. And again, if you like this video, please thumbs it up. And also, too, if you haven't subscribed and you're brand new here, please subscribe on the right-hand side below. We're doing lots of videos just like this one on my channel week after week, month after month, and even year after year. You can kind of check back on some of my older videos. I have archives, hundreds and hundreds of videos you can go back and check out in my YouTube channel. So if you go back and you just type in your favorite subject matter, maybe you just love flowers or you love still life, type in Chris Petri flowers or Chris Petri still life. You'll find that I've done already 10, 20, 30 videos just like this one, similar to this one, not exactly the same, but you'll learn and be able to practice on those too, which will give you a little more information, a little more of a different look on things. You know, I don't do every single video the same. I mix it up all the time. I'm always doing different subject matter in my videos. So I really try to break things up, make it different, make it interesting for you. So in any case, thanks again for watching. Thanks so much for being here. I'm excited that you're learning about watercolor, getting better and better all the time in your painting. And we'll see you soon on the next video, okay? Bye-bye.